हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय मैथ्स क्लासेस। और एवरीवन डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एन इम्पोर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट, दैट इज फाइंडिंग द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द रूट्स एंड द कोएफिशिएंट्स ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन x² + bx + c = 0। हियर इज द क्वेश्चन इन द एक्सरसाइज 3a एज क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। इफ अल्फा बीटा आर द रूट्स ऑफ ए क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन x² + bx + c = 0, देन फाइंड द values of the following in terms of ABC. So what are those following? Those I am considering these like this. So first one is alpha plus beta. As we know that sum of the roots of a quadratic equation is minus b by a. Everyone knows it. Okay. Then the second one is alpha into beta, product of the roots. The second one is alpha into beta, product of the roots. So alpha into beta. Okay. Then third one. Let me write one by one. Okay, alpha into beta is c by a. Now I am going to do 1/2. So I am dividing the sum of the roots by product of the roots. Then what do you get here? See, alpha plus beta whole by alpha beta. So this can be written as like this: alpha by alpha beta plus beta by alpha beta. Then we get here 1/(α + 1/β). Okay, this is the result. So if you want this value, we have to find alpha plus beta by alpha beta. So therefore 1/(α + 1/β) can be written as alpha plus beta by, that means sum of the roots by product of the roots, is equal to alpha plus beta value is minus b by a whole by alpha into beta, product of the roots is c by a, that is equal to minus b by a into reciprocal. So finally we get here 1/(α + 1/β) is equal to minus b by c. So it is the most important one. 1/(α + 1/β) is equal to minus b by c. And the fourth one is how to find the α² + β² value. Okay. To find the value of α² + β², just do one thing, that is square on both sides. As we know that sum of the roots is equal to minus b by a, from that we can find. And also, my dear friends, we can write a² + b² in terms of a + b and ab, like this: a + b² - 2ab. So in the same way, I am going to write α² + β² as α + β² - 2αβ. So if you see, simplify, we get again same expression. So what is the value of α + β? We know, minus b by a whole square minus 2 × α β. 2 × α β value is c by a. So now if you simplify, this is a reason, because of this we have written α² + β² in this form. So b² / a² - 2c/a. If you simplify, you get here b² - 2ac whole by a square. This is the value of α² + β². Okay, this is the value of α² + β². And the next one is α - β, modulus of α - β. So absolute value of α - β. So to find it, we have to find the value of α - β² So first to find out α - β². How to find α + β? We know clearly. It is easy to find α + β². But when come to the α - β², it is a little difficult, so that I am expressing this one in this form: α + β² - 4α × β. How do you know, sir? As we know that in algebraic identities, as we are learned in 8th class, a - b² can be written as a + b² - 4ab. If we simplify, you get same expression. Again, a - b² itself. Because a² + b² + 2ab - 4ab. If we simplify, you get here -2ab. So a² + b² - 2ab, we get like this. Now, if you find the value of α - β², you can find out the α - β value very easily. So, how to write it? As we know that the α + β value is minus b by a. And α β value is product of root c by a. It is very easy. So, let us substitute in that. Then it can be written as, now I am finding α - β² beta. So alpha plus beta is minus b by a whole square minus 4 into alpha into beta value is c by a. If we simplify, here we get minus b by a whole square is b square by a square minus 4 c by a. B square by a square minus 4 c by a. If you take LCM, a square is the LCM. So a square divides a square one time. So b square into 1 b square minus a divides a square a times. So that the quotient is a. So 4c into a 4ac. So this is the value of alpha minus beta whole square. But I want alpha minus beta only. So that shift square to that side. It becomes square root. So square root of b square minus 4ac whole by a square. So anyway, we get plus or minus, so the right modulus of alpha minus beta, that means absolute value of alpha minus beta is equal to square root of b square minus 4ac by a square. This is the most important results. So these are the 5 results. Now we have few more results. So keep pause and write the solutions. I'll take screenshot. I'm going to find the values of some other expressions in terms of a, b and c. Now alpha square minus beta square value. So alpha square minus beta square can be written as alpha plus beta into alpha minus beta. So as you know that alpha plus beta value is minus b by a into alpha minus beta value, just we have derived that is square root of b square minus 4ac by a square. So this can be written as minus b into square root of b square minus 4ac whole by square root of a square value is a into a square. So this is the value of alpha square minus beta square. It will be useful while solving some problems. My dear friends, if you remember some standard results, it is better for competitive exams. Or else again, every time derivation means little difficult, it takes time. Okay. So next, 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square. So take LCM. So alpha square beta square is LCM. Now we get here in the numerator alpha square plus beta square value. Already we have found the value of alpha square plus beta square. What is the value of alpha square plus beta square? In as the fourth point we have discussed that value. B square minus 2ac by a square. That is b square minus 2ac by a square whole by alpha square plus beta square. Alpha beta whole square. This can be written as alpha square plus beta square whole by alpha square into beta square. So it can be written as alpha beta whole square. But we cannot write alpha square plus beta square as alpha plus beta whole square. It is wrong. Okay. So here c by a whole square means c square by a square. Now here a square gets cancelled, remaining is b square minus 2ac by c square. This is the value of 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square. Therefore 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square is equal to b square minus 2ac by c square. Important result. Now 8th one. So here alpha by beta minus beta by alpha. This value we want. For that, take LCM again, alpha into beta. Here by cross multiplication we get alpha square minus beta square. Already we came to know that alpha square minus beta square value from 6th point. So the answer is minus b into square root of b square minus 4ac by a square. This is alpha square minus beta square value. Whole by alpha beta. So whole by alpha into beta means c by a. So if you write like this, it becomes minus b into square root of b square minus 4ac whole by a square into, if you bring this divisor denominator to the numerator, it becomes a by c. Here one a gets cancelled. So minus b into square root of b square minus 4ac by ac. Okay, this is the value of alpha by beta minus beta by alpha. Okay, but in our textbook they ask one question like this: find out the value of alpha by beta minus beta by alpha whole square. So for this you have to do square. Okay, then it becomes minus b into square root of b square minus 4ac whole by ac whole square. So this can be written as b square into b square minus 4ac whole by a square c square. That's it. A by b whole power m, a power m by b power m. So minus b whole square into square root of b square minus 4ac whole square by a square c square. So this is the result of alpha by beta minus beta by alpha whole square. My dear students, in this way you have to find the relation between the roots and coefficients of the given quadratic equation is very easy and important. Okay, let us discuss few more relations in this manner. Okay, now in this ninth one they are given alpha square plus beta square whole by alpha power minus 2 plus beta power minus 2 value. So this can be written as alpha square plus beta square, okay, let it be, by the denominator is having a two terms and also they have a negative powers, so that I can write it as 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square. So already we came to know the alpha square plus beta square value and 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square value. You have checked already as the second, third, fourth, fifth points are those only. See, alpha square plus beta square value is b square minus 2ac by a square whole by 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square value is b square minus 2ac by c square. So these are the values. So alpha square plus beta square value is b square minus 2ac by a square and 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square value is b square minus 2ac by c square. Now simplify. So just write like this. Bring the denominator to the numerator, then it, write that it's reciprocal, then b square minus 2ac, b square minus 2ac, b square minus 2ac gets cancelled, remaining is c square by a square. So this is the answer. So this is the answer for alpha square plus beta square whole by alpha to the power minus 2 plus beta power minus 2. Okay, clear? The next one, see my next one, that is alpha cube plus beta cube value. So alpha plus beta whole cube, you know the formula, but how to write alpha cube plus beta cube? As we know that a plus b whole cube formula can be expressed like this: a cube plus b cube plus 3ab of a plus b. Okay, from this we can write that a cube plus b cube formula like this: a plus b whole cube minus 3ab of a plus b. Okay, in the same way we can express alpha cube plus beta cube as like this. So alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 into alpha into alpha plus beta. So clearly we know the all formulas in this alpha plus beta value is minus b by a, alpha into beta is c by a, alpha plus beta value is minus b by a. Fatafat substituting that, then it becomes, therefore alpha cube plus beta cube can be expressed as alpha plus beta whole cube minus b by a whole cube minus 3 into alpha into beta, product of the roots formula is c by a into alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Now if you simplify it here, minus b cube by a cube minus into minus plus 3bc by a square. Now if you take out the LCM, it becomes a cube is the LCM. Here a cube divides a cube one time, so 1 into minus b cube minus b cube plus here a square divides a cube a times, so plus 3bc into a, that is plus 3abc. Therefore we can write the value of alpha cube plus beta cube like this: alpha cube plus beta cube is equal to 3abc minus b cube whole by a cube. Most important result. Okay, 3abc minus b cube by a cube. Now 11th one, that is alpha to the power 4 into beta power 7 plus alpha to the power 7 into beta power 4. So this can be expressed like this: alpha power 4 into beta power 7 can be written as beta power 4 into beta cube. Am I correct? Similarly, alpha power 4 into alpha power 7 into beta power 4. So if you observe, my dear students, here alpha power 4, beta power 4 is the common. Okay, if you take out common factor, as common factor alpha power 4 into beta power 4, then what is the remaining here? Beta cube plus here alpha, here alpha power 3, so alpha cube. Okay, now Here alpha power 4 and beta power 4 can be written as alpha beta whole cube, sorry, whole to the power of 4 into here alpha cube plus beta cube. Here already alpha cube plus beta cube value we have found in 10th problem. Yes, that is here alpha into beta value is c by a whole to the power of 4 into alpha cube plus beta cube value is 3abc minus b cube by a cube. Okay. It is a like a by b whole to the power of m. So a power m by b power m. So c power 4 by a power 4 into 3abc minus b cube by a cube. Okay. So final answer is c power 4 into 3abc minus b cube whole by a power 4 into a power 3 can be as a to the power of 7. So this is the final answer. It is the value of alpha power 4 into beta power 7 plus alpha power 7 into beta power 4. So important for 2 marks questions. My dear students, this is about the part 4. So it is a question in exercise 3A. This is 4th question. Okay. So in this 4th question, they don't ask everything from this. They will select any one or two and they give for 2 marks question. Most important frequently asked questions. Dear students, I hope you are clear about the concept what I have discussed in this video lecture. Please like our videos and comment, share with your friends without fail. And my students, many of you not subscribing our channel, even you are watching, even though you are not subscribing, please subscribe our channel, click on the bell icon to get the notifications. We will meet in the next session with another concept. Till then,